Hello. It's my absolute pleasure to present to you David Warner's profile picture. Finally ready for him on this, his 21st birthday. What do you mean he's turning 22? Oh no, I'm late again, son of a bitch! Sweetie, sweetie, I'm here, boys. Let's get down to business. Only an hour late, but that's a new world record. Hi-ya! Time to get down some ideas. Oh. It's David's birthday, people! We need to do a video for him. Anybody got any ideas?
Who the fuck is David?
Does Davis like Cajun food?
Davis! Davis! Get in here and clean some table!
Hey, hey, hey! I'm not gonna clean that table! Bye!
How about we do a video about his sex life?
I have a great idea, guys. Why don't we do a montage of all the films he likes?
Remember when David made that video that NASA took down?
The video in question was only 4 letters long. It was ASDFQR, whatever, it doesn't matter. But it was using stolen intellectual property from NASA. Our logos, our designs. We couldn't allow that. We took this Warner man, this David Warner, to a civil suit up to the Supreme Court, the highest Supreme Court. Now, We did what we could. We sued a 17-year-old. It was natural. We wanted our property back. What happened was A gun battle lasting 17 hours and 23 minutes, approximately. There were no survivors. Except him. You may have heard of it in NASA versus Warner. Now, anyway, what happened in this video is not important. It's in space, but it's not important. The question is, it's still out there somewhere.
That'll do. Or we could talk about the time he got drunk at a Mormon wedding.
So about 9 months ago, this hooligan came to our little church and decided to smuggle in what is commonly known as whiskey. He decided he wanted to smuggle it in to a nice little tie. It looked very sensible, but unfortunately, it had the devil's water in it. And he decided that during an emotional, dog-related wedding service, that he was going to become intoxicated and remained intoxicated for the entire reception. He was promptly asked to leave. Then, once it was discovered that he was intoxicated and asked to leave, his driver couldn't figure out what exit to use, so this intoxicated man decided to go as the verbal cue to turn at that exit. What a terrible man.
Was that good?
Yes!
Alright, get out.
I have a story to tell. I was once a young Hollywood starlet by the name of Tony Caproni, and I was hired on a production of Bill Wye the Something Guy when I was only 7 years old. I was one of the backup singers for his opening sequence. Did a good job, got paid well. It was the start of a new career for me. But it turns out, there ain't no jobs in this business for a dino like me. The producers don't want us. They want people with longer arms, they says. I was so desperate for money, I turned to the only job I could, the lowest of the low. I became a knife salesman. And then I blew all that money on cocaine. So now I fall asleep each night in a newspaper, dreaming of a brighter, better tomorrow. And that's my tragic backstory. And it's all because Hollywood is run by the Jap!
This is stupid! Let's go to Steak and Shake.
I can rest easy knowing I'm not gonna have chronic diarrhea tonight.